Welcome back to your chemistry class. Today we are going to discuss about our same chapter 3, that is atoms and molecules. See what we have discussed in our previous class, that is about Dalton's atomic theory, that is postulates of Dalton's atomic theory, and then we have discussed about symbols of an element. So how will you calculate the symbol of an element? That is Berzelius, very first he used that symbol, that is with the help of first letter R from first letter and other letters from an element, it is chosen as a symbol, isn't it? Before that, Dalton gave some symbols for elements. It is difficult to identify. Then, that is Berzelius gave symbol for an element, that is first letter or first letter and other letters from an element is chosen as a symbol. So, in this way, we are writing symbols nowadays. That is what a symbol first. That is chemical symbol is nothing. It is a short way of representing an element. Short way of representing an element. Already said to you, nowadays we have 118 elements are there. So all the elements we can't keep it in the form of their full name. So for that we need the short way of representing element, that is symbol. So chemically, how will you write the chemical symbols? That is, I said to you, the first letter or the first letter and second letter from the its element name. For example, hydrogen, what is the first letter of this hydrogen? It is H. So you can choose this H as the symbol for hydrogen. Same like this, helium, what is this first letter? Again H. So you can choose again H as the symbol for helium. So we can choose first letter what? Second letter. See, how will you mention the symbol? Always first letter you should write capital letter and second letter is a small letter. So in this way you need to write the chemical symbols, isn't it? And from some elements we can choose from its Latin name also. See, how will you choose? For example, if you will take some elements like sodium. So what's the symbol for sodium? What's the symbol for sodium? It is Na. But how we are taking this Na? In the sodium there is no N, there is no A. But how we are taking this as a symbol for sodium? With its Latin name. What is Latin name? That is Latin name of sodium. What is that? Natrium. So from this first letter and second letter we are choosing as a symbol. Same like this, potassium. So what is the symbol for potassium? It is K. What is Latin name? It is Kalium. What is Latin name? It is Kalium. From which we are taking first letter, it is K is the symbol for potassium. And same like this, we are using generally silver. Silver, what's its symbol? It is Ag. So what's the Latin name? It is argentum. So how we are taking? Already Ar, organ is there. So we are taking first letter and third letter. So Ag is the symbol. Same like this, we can take it for gold also. So what's the symbol for gold? It is Au. How will you take it from Latin name? It is Rm. So first two letters we are taking. Same like this, do you know mercury? Mercury, what is its Latin name means? It is hydrogenum. From that we are taking it is Hg, that is hydra. From hydra we are taking H. From drum we are taking G. So hydrogenum is the Latin name for mercury. So Hg is the symbol. So plumbum, that is, do you know what is plumbum? It is nothing. Lead. Lead, the symbol is Pb. What's the Latin name? It is plumbum. See, from plumb we are taking P and from bum we are taking B. So Pb is the symbol for lead. So tin. What is this? Sn. Tin. What is symbol? Sn. So Latin name? Thallium. So from first letter and fourth letter we are taking, it is Sn, it is the symbol for tin. Same like this, you can take it from for iron. What is its symbol? Fe, Latin name ferrum. So copper, see first letter C, second letter O, but we are using symbol as Cu. How we are taking from its Latin name? It is cuprum. So likewise, we can take symbol from its Latin name also. So symbol is the short way of representing an element by using first letter or first letter with other letter from its element. So always first letter you should write capital letter and second letter and small letter. So try. So with the help of this, next we are going to discuss about chemical formula. That time we have to know about what are the symbols for elements. With the help of symbols, we can write the chemical formula of a compound. Isn't it? Okay. See, so we know very well these are symbols of an element. So we know very well what is atom. What is atom? That is, atom is made up of very, very, very smallest particles that cannot be divided further. This is proposed by Dalton, John Dalton. See, same John Dalton, he proposed the atomic mass of an element also. What is atomic mass? You have to know about what is atomic mass. That is mass of an element. So how will you find that atomic mass? We are telling atom is too small, it is very, very small. That particle is, we can't see with the help of naked eye. We can't see with the help of microscope. See, but how will you identify the mass of an atom? That is too difficult. So we can't, mass of an atom is too difficult. We can't use that for calculations because it is too small. For example, atomic mass, for example, we can say that, for example, atomic mass for hydrogen. Do you know hydrogen is an element? The symbol is H. So do you know what is the atomic mass for this hydrogen means? It is C. 1.673 into 10 to the power minus 24 C. So before this we have to write 24 zeros we have to add. Isn't it? So it is too small. So like this, the mass of an atom is very, very, very small. So we can't use these for using calculation. So for that, we have to find this atomic mass in the form of whole numbers. Isn't it? For that, in earlier scientists, they have used 16 oxygen. 16 is used as a standard mass. But nowadays, they are using it as carbon 12. Do you know what is carbon? It's an element, you know very well. In 1961 onwards, we are using carbon 12 isotope as used as a standard. With the help of this, carbon 12 isotope is used as a standard with the help of this. Nowadays, we are calculating the mass of an element, that is atomic mass. So how will you calculate? Do you know what is mean by carbon 12 isotope? This is, for example, carbon is one element. This carbon, what is the atomic number and mass number? Do you know what is atomic number of carbon? It is 6. What's the atomic number of carbon? It is 6. Isn't it? How will you calculate the atomic number? The number of protons or the number of electrons is considered as an atomic number. See, for carbon, number of protons also 6, number of electrons also 6. Protons also 6, number of electrons also 6, and number of neutrons also 6. About this we will discuss further in this lesson. Listen, so 6. So how will you find the mass number? Means number of protons plus number of neutrons is mass number. So what's the mass number of carbon? It is 12. So this carbon 12 is taken as a standard mass. With the help of this, we can identify other mass of an element. So how will you take this? For example, if you are taking one watermelon, if you are taking one watermelon, suppose consider this watermelon as a carbon atom. See, now we are cutting this into 12 parts. How many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Like this, this is considered, this is one watermelon. We are cutting this watermelon into 12 equal parts. From this one part of this watermelon is taken as a standard mass of the carbon element. That is, I will tell you clearly, do you know, with the help of this, we can write the atomic, relative atomic mass. Listen, that is, with the help of this carbon, we can write, that is, relative atomic mass. Do you know what is relative atomic mass? That is nothing. The relative atomic mass is the average atomic average mass of the atom as compared to 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon 12 atom. Listen clearly. Relative atomic mass. See, this is nothing. The average of the atom as compared to 1/12 the mass of one carbon 12 atom. That is, see, 1/12. How do you spell this? 1/12. 1/12 the mass of one carbon 12 atom is considered as a standard. With the help of this, we can calculate the relative atomic mass. See, how it is possible, I will tell you. Suppose, if you are taking one more element, that is, if you are taking helium, consider, here we have one balance. One side we are keeping helium, and another side we have to balance this helium with the help of mass. So, from this carbon 12, we have 12 parts of carbon here. So, from this, we are taking one part. Here we are keeping one part, but it is not balanced. Again we are keeping one part. Now also it is not balanced. Again we are keeping one part. Now also it is not balanced. And again we are keeping one more part. Now it is balanced. So from this what we can identify, that is 4 is the atomic mass of helium. 4 is the relative atomic mass of helium. Same like this, suppose if you are taking nitrogen, see, if we are taking nitrogen, we need to keep 14 parts. Like one part, we need to keep 14 parts, then only the nitrogen becomes balanced. So what's the mass of nitrogen? That is 14. Same like this, suppose we are taking magnesium, we have to keep like this 24 parts. Then only the magnesium mass of one atom of magnesium gets balanced. So we can say that the mass of helium, the relative atomic mass of helium is 4. The relative atomic mass of nitrogen is 14. The relative atomic mass of magnesium is 24. Like this, 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon 12 is taken as a standard. With the help of this, we can calculate the relative atomic mass of other elements. So from this, we can calculate the relative atomic mass of other elements. We are using this relative atomic mass unit, that is atomic mass unit. It is represented with the help of AMU. AMU is nothing. It is atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit. It is AMU. We use it as a unit for this atomic mass. But nowadays, based on IUPAC recommendation. What is IUPAC in last class? I informed you, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. This is called what? IUPAC. So based on this only, we are naming all the elements and compounds as well. So, this based on this IUPAC recommendation, nowadays, instead of this AMU, we are using U as the unit of atomic mass. That is, U is nothing, it is unified mass. U is unified mass. So what is one atomic mass unit? What is one atomic mass unit? That is 1/12. How will you spell this? 1/12. 1/12 the mass of 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon 12. 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon 12 are 1/12 are 1/12 the mass of one carbon 12 is considered as an one atomic mass unit. Listen carefully. One atomic mass unit is equal to 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon 12. Nowadays we are using it as a unified mass. What is this? That is, unified mass is equal to 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon 12 is considered as a one atomic mass unit or unified mass. Or unified mass. So with the help of this we can calculate the atomic mass based on carbon 12 is used as a standard. Carbon 12 is used as a standard. In 1961 onwards, that is universally accepted, that is carbon 12, atomic mass of carbon 12 is used as a standard mass, and with the help of that we can calculate the other mass of an element. So this is called atomic mass of an element. With the help of carbon 12 we can find out the other mass of an element, the atomic mass. So next we are going to discuss about molecules. What are molecules? That is, we know that atom is very very smallest particle. Atom is very very smallest particle. That is, two or more atoms chemically combined to form molecules. Two or more atoms chemically combined to form molecules. See, molecules we can divide it into two types. That is, molecule of elements and molecule of compounds. So we can divide this molecules into two types, that is molecule of elements and also molecule of compounds. See, what is called molecule of elements and what is called molecule of compounds? We are going to discuss now. Listen. See, molecule of elements are nothing. That is, atoms of the same element. Atoms of the same element combine together to make molecule of elements. See, two or more same elements. For example, if two or more same elements, like two oxygen atoms combine to form O2. So same elements combine to form molecule. So this is a molecule of an element. Oxygen element. Same like this. Suppose if we will three oxygen element combine to form O3 molecule. This is ozone molecule. And two nitrogen atoms combine to form nitrogen molecule. So atoms of the same elements combine to form molecules are called molecule of elements. Atoms of the same elements combine to form molecule are called molecule of elements. But some elements only, that is, exist in the form of single element, like rare gases. We know rare gases will not react with other elements easily, like helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Like these cases, it will exist in single form, that is, will not combine with other elements to create molecule. So these are molecule of elements. Molecule of elements are nothing. Atoms of the same elements combine together to form molecule of elements. Same like this, what are molecule of compounds? See, that is, atoms of different elements. Atoms of different elements chemically combined in a fixed ratio to form molecule of compounds. For example, we can say this, water, it is a molecule. See, hydrogen is different element, oxygen is different element. So both different elements combine together to make a water molecule. So like this, atoms of different elements, atoms of different elements chemically combined in a fixed ratio. How will you get this water molecule? That is 2:1 ratio, hydrogen 2 and oxygen 1. 2 hydrogen atom, 1 oxygen atom. It's 2 hydrogen elements, 1 oxygen element. So in the form of 2:1 ratio, we get water molecule. Likewise, atoms of the different elements, combined in the definite ratio to form molecule. Same like this, we can say that carbon dioxide, that is carbon is different element, oxygen is different element. Same like this, we can say that hydrogen chloride, HCl, hydrogen is different element, Cl, chlorine is different element. Sulfuric acid, in this we will get hydrogen, sulfur, oxygen, these are different elements. Likewise, atoms of same elements combined to form molecule of elements, atoms of different elements combined to form molecule of compounds. So these are called the molecule of elements and these are molecule of compounds. From this we can say atomicity of an element. Do you know what is meant by atomicity? Do you know the word, what is atomicity? Listen, I'll tell you. That is atomicity. See, atomicity is nothing. The number of atoms, present in a molecule of compound. The number of atoms present in the molecule is called, atomicity. For example, only suppose if you are taking neon, how many atoms present here? Only one atom. Neon exists in the form of single entity, only one atom. So what is the atomicity of this neon atom? It is monoatomic. Mono means one. So monoatomic, the atomicity is only one. And then suppose if you are taking oxygen, how will it exist in the form of O2? So oxygen is diatomic in nature. The atomicity of oxygen is diatomic, that is two oxygen atoms combined to form this molecule. So atomicity of oxygen is diatomic. Same like this, suppose if you are taking H2SO4, sulfuric acid, what's the atomicity? See here, 2 hydrogen, 1 sulfur, 4 oxygen. 2 hydrogen, 1 sulfur, 4 oxygen, totally 7. The number of atoms here, it is 7. So this is polyatomic. Poly means many. So many atoms combined together to form this. So it is called polyatomic. What is this? Polyatomic. The number of atoms present in the molecule. See how many number of atoms present in this molecule? It is 7. So it is more than 4, we can say it is polyatomic. Same like this, ozone, O3. Number of atoms 3. So it is triatomic. Suppose phosphorus exists in the form of C4, we can say it is tetraatomic. Sulfur always combined in the form of S8. We can say this also it is polyatomic. So what's the number of atoms present here? 8. So the atomicity is 8. It is polyatomic. So atomicity is nothing. That is the number of atoms present in the molecule is called atomicity. Only one atom is present, it is called monoatomic. Two atoms are present in the molecule, it is called diatomic. Three elements are present in the molecule, it is triatomic. Four elements are present in the molecule, it is tetraatomic. More than four, we can say it is polyatomic. So, how many number of atoms present in the molecule? Based on this, we can say what's the atomicity of a molecule. Is it clear? So, next, we are going to discuss about ions. Listen. See, now we are going to discuss about ions. See, what are ions? Ion is different from molecules. See, already we have discussed about molecules. What are molecules? Molecules are electrically neutral group of two or more atoms chemically bonded together. Molecules are neutral group of two or more atoms that is chemically bonded together. It is neutral group, there is no charge. See here we are going to discuss about ions. What are ions? See, before going there, you have to know about the difference between ion and ion. This is ion, it is an element, the symbol is Fe, you know very well, and this is different from ions. Ions are charged particles. Generally, ions are charged particles. And ions are positively and also negatively, positively and also negatively charged atoms or group of atoms. See, ions are what? Ions are charged particles. Ions are charged particles. What are ions? Generally, ions are charged particles. Ions are charged particles. That means an ion is a positively or negatively charged atom or group of atoms. See, you know that we have different types of ions, that is positive ions and then negative ions. That is positively charged ions are called cations. And then negatively charged ions are called anions. See, before this, you have to know about atoms can be divided into subatomic particles like protons, electrons, and neutrons. See, inside the atom, we have these particles like protons, electrons, and neutrons. In this, protons are positively charged particles and electrons are negatively charged particles and neutrons are neutral particles. About this we will discuss in your next chapter, isn't it? So see, based on these topics, that is proton is positively charged and electron is negatively charged, these two makes an atom, it is electrically neutral. See, based on this, we know very well it is ions are charged particles. In this, positively charged ions are called cations and the negatively charged ions are called anions. For example, we can say that for cations, positively charged particles, we can say that is sodium ion Na+, and then magnesium ion Mg2+, sodium ion, magnesium ion, and then ammonium ion NH4+, and so on. Same like this, we can say some examples for anions. That is chloride ion, as well as fluoride ion, as well as oxide ion. Chloride, fluoride, oxide, as well as sulfate ion, etc. Oxide and also sulfate. Sulfate ion, carbonate ion, etc. Listen, these are some examples of cations and anions. See, just I am telling that is Na+, Mg2+, NH4+. We know what are these? That are, this is plus. We know very well, plus means it indicates positive charge. See here, Cl-, F-, O2-, SO42-, and CO32-. These indicate it is minus, it is negative. So these indicate negative charged ions, and these indicate positive charged ions. So we are calling these are cations, these are anions. Do you know how these cations and anions come? Do you know how will you get these cations and anions? Listen, see, we know very well that is metals are electropositive in nature, non-metals are electronegative in nature. Already we have discussed in our 8th grade this. That is, what about metals? They are electropositive in nature. That means during chemical reaction, suppose if you are taking Na, what is this Na? It is sodium metal, isn't it? It is sodium metal, sodium element. Okay, so this sodium element, during chemical reaction, what will happen is, it will lose one electron. For that, you have to know how many electrons are present in this sodium. What's the atomic number of sodium? It is 11. That means, in sodium, totally 11 electrons are present. In that 11 electrons are arranged like this in sodium. About this we will discuss in your next chapter. Okay. This is number of electrons present in different cells. Different cells, we can say like that. So about this we will discuss in our next chapter. Just listen. See, sodium generally has 11, total are 11 electrons. So that atomic number of sodium we can say that is 11. Isn't it? So this sodium during chemical reaction, it will lose one electron. Sodium will lose one electron. It will lose one electron. Totally it has 11 electrons. It will lose one electron. So loss of electron will give positive charge to the atom. Now it will lose one electron. So it has only 2 and 8. So totally it has 11 electrons. One electron it will lose, and totally it has 10 electrons after reaction. This is called sodium ion. This is called sodium ion. See, now you want to know the answer. Why this sodium will lose electron? Because the sodium will lose electron because to attain stable state during chemical reaction, all the elements will involve to attain stable state. So that's why it will lose electron or gain electron or it will share electron. Okay, so about that we will discuss later. Just listen, this is sodium metal. Generally metals will lose electron to attain stable state. Attain stable state. Why it want to attain stable state means, you know that generally in nature we have noble gases, that is rare gases. That rare gases generally it has like helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. These are called rare gases. The atomic number of this gas is 2, 10, 18 and so on. Isn't it? See here, see, to attain this rare gases, noble gases like this, it will lose electron or gain electron or share electron because these noble gases are already stable and state in nature. Okay, so to attain nearest noble gas, it will lose or gain or will share. See, sodium, how many electrons it has? It is 11. So what is this nearest stable state? It is 10. So it wants to attain stable state means it wants to get only 10 electrons. So this will lose one extra electron. So it will get positive charge, Na plus. So see here, how many protons are here? It is 11 protons and the electron also 11. Isn't it? But see here now, it is total already 11 only, but only electron only it is last one electron 10. So due to this, you can identify only during chemical reaction, the transfer of electron only takes place. There is no change in protons because protons are present deep inside the nucleus. So only electrons only present in outer side. So that only involves in the chemical reaction. So generally metals lost electrons to form positive ions, and same like this non-metals will gain electrons. For example, we can say that is fluorine, isn't it? This is fluorine, it is one of the non-metal. Fluorine is one of the non-metal. Same like this, chlorine also one of the non-metal. If you will take chlorine, what will happen? Atomic number of chlorine is 17. What's the atomic number of chlorine? 17. Like this, chlorine has proton also 17, electron also 17. Isn't it? Proton also 17, electron also 17. Why I am telling proton is 17, electron is 17 means? Because atomic number is the proton number or electron number. That we will discuss later. So it has 17 protons and 17 electrons. So in electronic configuration it will be like this. It will be like this. That is arrangement of electrons in different cells. Okay. So about that, I will discuss you later. Listen. So see here, which is the nearest stable state, this chlorine will attain nearest stable state of argon, because this is 17, argon is 18. So it wants to attain nearest stable state means it wants to gain one more electron. It wants to gain one more electron, then it will attain negative charge. So now already for protons, 17 protons are present. Electrons already only 17, but gaining of electron is 1. So totally electron is now 18. So you know very well, protons are positively charged particles, electrons are negatively charged particles. So one electron is extra, so one charge is extra. Same like you see here, one proton is extra, so it's getting positive charge. Same like this, suppose if we have it is, whether it is oxygen means, only it has 8 electrons and nearest stable state is near, so it needs 2 more electrons, so it will get O2 minus. Okay, suppose if we will take magnesium, that atomic number is 12, so nearest stable state near, so it will last 2 electrons, so loss of electron gives positive charge. So like this, ions are nothing, and ion is a positively or negatively charged atom or group of atoms. See here, these are single atoms to form ions. See here, group of atoms, nitrogen, hydrogen. Different atoms combine to form charge, that is ions. And same like the sulfur, oxygen combine to form sulfate ions. Carbon, oxygen combine to form carbonate ions. So like this, single atom or group of atoms combine to form ions. So these are called ions, cations and anions. Cations are positively charged ions and anions are negatively charged ions. And we can say these group of ions are called polyatomic ions. Polyatomic ions, that means a group of atoms with charge. What is called poly means many. So many atoms combined with charge is called polyatomic ions. And group of atom with charge, it is called polyatomic ion. It may be positive or negative. So whether it is positive, that is polyatomic cation. Whether it is negative, polyatomic anion. So and group of atom with charge is called polyatomic ion. What is called? Polyatomic ion. Group of atoms carrying charge is called polyatomic ion. Isn't it? So ions are charged particles, positively charged ions are cations, and the negatively charged ions are anions, and cations will form with the help of loss of electrons, and anions will form with the help of gain of electrons. See, keep it in your mind, only during chemical reaction, the exchange of electrons only takes place. There is no change in protons. Isn't it? Okay? So listen, next, we are going to discuss about chemical formula. Do you know what is meant by chemical formula? See, what is chemical symbol already we have discussed. It is a short way of representing an element. See, this chemical formula is nothing, it is a short way of representing a compound or molecule. Short way of representing a molecule or compound. It is a short way of representing a molecule or a compound as called what? It is a chemical formula. Chemical symbol is the short way of representing elements only. Chemical formula is the short way of representing a molecule or compound. It's called chemical formula. See, for writing chemical formula, you have to write step by step. First, you have to know the symbol of both cation as well as anion. See, do you know, for writing chemical formula, we have to follow some steps. Isn't it? First, you have to write cation in left side, anion in right side. Suppose write the chemical formula of sodium chloride. How will you write the chemical formula of sodium chloride? So how will you write for this? First you have to write the symbols of cations and anions side by side. That is, what is the symbol for sodium? That is Na. What is the symbol for sodium? You have to write the metal symbol, that is sodium, it is left side, and chloride, that is negative ion, is right side. See, do you keep it in your mind? Sodium ion, chloride ion. Whenever we are telling that passing ion, just we are adding the element name with ion. But see here, whenever we are using negative ion, we are using, that is sulfide ion, sulfate ion, sulfide ion. This is sulfide, sulfate, sulfide, chloride, chlorate. Like this we will use. See, always negative ions we will use with IDE, ATE or ITE. Okay. But positive ion we will write the element name with ion. Whether it is magnesium ion. Whether it is calcium, calcium ion. Whether it is sodium, sodium ion. But negative charge ion, whether it is oxygen, you have to write, it is oxide ion. We have to add IDE. So oxide, sulfide, sulfate, sulfide. So in negative ion, we will add IDE, ATE, or ITE like this. So you have to keep it in your mind. See, this is sodium Na, chloride, that is chlorine ion, that is chloride Cl. Isn't it? So first you have to write the symbols side by side. Then second step, you have to write the valencies of this element. For that you have to know what is mean by valency. What is mean by valency? About that valency we will discuss in your next chapter, but I will explain you, listen, valency. It is the combining capacity of an element. Valency is the combining capacity of an element. During chemical reaction, the loss of electron or gain of electron or sharing of electron is said to be valency. See, for example, we have discussed that the sodium lost one electron to form Na plus. Same like this, chlorine gain one electron to form Cl minus, isn't it? So this Na plus, only one electron lost, so valency is one. One electron gain, valency is one. Same like this, oxide, it will gain two electrons, so valency is two. Valency is two. And then same like this, magnesium lost two electrons, valency is two. Like this, during chemical reaction, loss of electrons or gain of electrons or sharing of electrons is said to be valency. So you have to know the valency. What's the valency for sodium? That is, actually sodium will lose one electron, so valency one. Chlorine also will gain one electron, valency one. Next step, if any compound radical is there, you must put within bracket, there is no compound radical. What is that? That is two or more atom with charge, that is polyatomic ion. If any polyatomic ion means, you should put within bracket. There is no polyatomic ion. Only it is Na plus, so valency one, Cl minus, valency one. So one, so no problem. Then next, you have to crisscross the valency. That means this valency you have to write here, and this valency you have to write here. Like this, you have to write. See here, Na, and you have to write chlorine valency, and Cl, and you have to write the sodium valency here. So both valencies are same, no need to write. Both valencies are same, no need to write. So what's the formula for sodium chloride? It is NaCl. What's the formula for sodium chloride? It is NaCl. Suppose, instead of this, now I am asking, write the formula for, that is Sodium, sodium sulfate. How do you write? One symbol for sodium, that is Na. Charge Na plus and sulfate, SO4, 2 minus. That means Na plus means valency 1. SO4, 2 minus means valency 2. Isn't it? And here, right now, viscosity valency is before that. What is the compound radical here? That is polyatomic ion. SO4 sulfate. Isn't it? See, so Na, and you have tried the valency, sulfate valency here, and sulfate SO4, right within bracket. And what's the valency for sodium? 1. So 1 means no need to write. So what's the formula for sodium sulfate? Na2SO4. Na2SO4. Same like this, suppose instead of sodium sulfate, suppose I am asking whether it is aluminium sulfate. How will you write? Aluminium, Al, it is Al3+, because aluminium atomic number 13, it will lose 3 electrons. And sulfate, SO4, 2-. So valency, aluminium valency 3, sulfate valency 2. Then crisscross, before that compound radical, put within bracket. So Al valency here 2, and then sulfate SO4, write in bracket, and aluminium valency 3, you want to write here. Suppose there is no bracket, what will happen? You will write SO43, isn't it? The 3 will come here. So this is not a correct method. You have to write any compound radical, you must put within bracket. That is polyatomic ion, you have to put within bracket. So Al2, aluminium, that is sulfate valency 2, and SO4 sulfate and valency 3. So Al2SO4 thrice is the formula for aluminium sulfate. It's the chemical formula for aluminium sulfate. So like this, first you need to write the positive radical and negative radical side by side. Positive radical in left side, negative radical in right side. Then you need to write the valences below the symbols. Okay, next, if any compound radical is there, you must put within bracket. Then you need to crisscross the valencies, then interchange the valency and write. Finally, without charge, you need to write the formula. No need to mention the charge finally. So what's the formula for sodium chloride? It is NaCl. While writing N cap A small, C cap L small. Same like this. And sodium sulfate, Na2SO4. And same like this, aluminium sulfate, Al2SO4 thrice. So like this, without charge, finally you have to write the formula. So this is the way to write chemical formula. So listen children, what we have discussed today. Today we have discussed about what are molecules and what are ions and what are cations and what are anions and what is chemical formula and how you write the chemical formula. So revise this video carefully, and if you have any doubt, go through once again. And thank you, children.